Well, hopefully you guys are not using AT&T. Oh, you are? Okay, well, all of your data has been breached and it is all over the interwebs. My suggestion to you, Cue the Fire, is change your social security number because everyone has that now, and your password. Also, for those of you that are like, show me the numbers, it's probably 10, right? 73 million of you. Also, pop the confetti, happy Easter, and hopefully you guys worship a god that actually came out of the grave and isn't still in it. And also, Kitty stopped me and she said, you gotta take your clothes off, you cannot wear black today, so you have some spots. Also, for those of you that have been asking, where is Kitty? Well, we've been having technical difficulties. Kitty, to let him know that you're alive.
I'm alive!
Say hi.
Hi!
It only took me about 2 months to fix Kitty. So she's back, Skylar's back. And anyways, more bad news. China, this is crazy. Talk about tinfoil hat time. China issued advisory for citizens visiting the United States. So hey, if you happen to be Chinese, I think they want you back because safety precautions, be prepared for various expected situations. Something's going to be going down soon. Everyone from China, I guess you got to go. Could it possibly be a nuclear strike? Oh, wait, nuclear. See? You can teach an old dog new tricks. Putin, his friend, his BFS forever, predicts nuclear strike most likely coming. So have your bunker ready. I have a suggestion for Joey B. Let's not kill us all. Actually, breaking news, he's a little upset. Biden condemns Jesus for rising again on Trans Day. And also, for those of you that subscribe, that's what I said yesterday, that today is the day. And I'm kind of digging this fight against God. It's okay, bring it. I think I know who's going to win. I actually wonder, how much time left do you think we have before the world gets wiped out in fire? Because the first time it was flooded, the second time it's going to be fire. Just FYI. Oh, hey, can I connect dots? Nuclear strike? Bravo, it's not like Sodom and Gomorrah. Oh, really? On to the news. U.S. interest in how this really ends. I mean, we already know how it ends, but here are some of the birthing pains of that ending. Number one, we are just like Rome, and I will show you. Also, money, interest, debt, bonds, bondage, Janet spending just the interest payment alone at the end of this year out of your taxes is going to be $1.6 trillion of credit card interest debt. You ain't paying anything off. That's just the interest. And I've been warning and you're like, well, we'll be okay. And I'm telling you, I know it doesn't happen overnight, but it is zooming. It's like magnets, like right at the end. Some of you guys like, drives me crazy when I touch silver together. Sorry. I'm a teacher. I need to make a point. It needs to go in your head, right? But you are witnessing everything. And this is like the whole world is turned upside down. The things that are right are wrong. Things that are wrong are right. It's rampant. And then it ends. Now, when? I don't know. But I'm telling you, you're running out of time. But guys, you can see the end if you just start in cities. And this is where it begins and it just spreads. And it's the same thing plays out over and over, whether it's Rome or whether it is America, starts in the city and there it goes. And then these guys come in and say, oh, we're gonna solve this right now. Everything, whatever needs to be, yeah, you go, Newsom. California governor, here you go. To deploy 500 surveillance cameras. So do you see? As it burns, they're like, we'll fix it. Now we're going to basically see everywhere you go. And by surveillance, we'll stop all of these problems. No, you're not. I mean, we could walk around and see it happening. You need the government to? I mean, in New York City, you could just randomly get knocked out. And you know what people will do? Zero. They will film it. They'll put it on TikTok. Multiple TikTokers claim they were randomly punched in the face by strangers while walking in New York City. It's in the city. What is right is wrong. What is wrong is right. I mean, the next story, firefighters forced to remove flag honoring that number, which I cannot say on YouTube. Heroes after lefty poll question if it's a political symbol. When getting back to what I was saying about the fall of Rome, and look at the comment section too. Thank you for everyone. I read all of them. Some of you guys put some really thoughtful history down there. But the United States of America has forgotten. It's past. There's like no struggle for survival. They're like, oh, I'll get a STEMI or whatever the government gives you. And whether it's Texas, California, Texas residents start receiving $500 a month, direct payments. New York City gives migrants debit cards. It's okay. It's all, we got you. Know where the money's coming from. It's coming from you, which you have to pay this back in interest. I just bumped this a couple years. Interest on debt, just the interest. In a few years, it's almost going to be $3 trillion. The game is up. And the government and people, they're like, it's over. They'll put it on the card. It doesn't matter. And I was actually excited. 2020, 2021, I'm like, good job, you guys. Financially responsible turns into financially off the chart, irresponsible from the top all the way to the bottom. Just like Rome, selfish, lazy, pleasure seeking, just whatever. It's the market go up, digits go up. And when it stops going up, we'll just burn this place down. And that is my fear. So right now, enjoy the day because this doesn't last. I've traveled the world since the day I turned 18. And 2 years in Europe, traveling, still traveling, seeing, watching how cities crumble. Before they do, it's the same mantra. Well, it's not going to happen to us and this is just going to keep going. No, it's not. Actually, I left my cursor on where I would be living. This were a city. Yes, way outside. Because when it happens, it will be like a blink of an eye and then you will reap what you sow. And right now we're just in that weird. How can this just go on? But it doesn't. It will end. Like the squatters, the lunatics, the cities, the Sam Bankman-Fried. What happens, whether it's Sam or whatever, the math at the end finally adds up and you go to jail or whatever the consequence is in life. For him, what is it, 25 years? And did you guys check this out? Sam Bankman-Fried might be eating a lot of rice, almonds, and Skittles. If he wants to stay vegan, I guess he's going to stay vegan. I'm going to say this boy is going to be eating a lot of meat. Although I get it. How do I make money from this? You are terrible. All right, let's take a look at AT&T. I always start off by hitting the wrong button. I start with A, but it's actually T. Oh, and if you're currently holding it, may God be with you. Just on this thing, I see two things. One, I see a channel up. So make sure this is on the weekly. Don't break that line. So I see even a bigger channel just so you'll go, oh, okay. And let me help you. You clone it. You can bring it right down here. Wow, isn't this neat? You happen to be at the top of a channel that goes back to all the way to 2018. So before I forget, it is Easter. So start the clock. Ends at midnight if you want to grab how to do this stuff, how to make digits go up. 80% off whatever course you want. Start with swing trading because you'll learn how to do this. And do bear market. Market go down. You can make money going down. And options. Those are the three. You can do it like that. You will probably learn more and make more than you ever did from whatever that college thing gave you that I was a professor and I taught, but I taught this stuff. And check this out. Let's go back 30 years. I'm like, I bought AT&T 30 years ago. You want to know how much money I've made over the course of 30 years? Because buy and holding always works. It's the same. And for some reason, people just think mathematically or magically like, I've held AT&T for my entire life and I still have the same amount. And honestly, you could have less now. Like, but look at how much money you could have made if you just would have swung it up and then swung it down. And if you had indicators that told you this is your bottom, that's your bottom. Look how high we are. Look at this. I mean, you're not like that one. I can't see that little arrow comes on. You're not that high, but you are in a channel heading lower. I honestly don't think AT&T is a great trade right now because there's not like a confirmation. That is why also I have watch lists of lots of time, hours and hours and hours every single day on these things, on setups just for you. What's going down? FMC. Do you see? It hits my trampoline. It's below the 200. It has a 9 count. It now fell one candle below the Bravo 9. And I also trade market go up. DLR. Do you see? It's like opposite day. Bounces off. Rise. Look at ACHE. ACHC. Why do I want to say E? Beat down. 9 count. Trampoline. 200. Up. While the world burns, you could take advantage of it going up. Going down with even a little bit, make that savings per family, right? That's embarrassing. Come on. I mean, this all ends while everyone's having fun, putting on the credit card. it's gonna implode. It's gonna blow up just like it did in 2020. Oh, let me give you some correlations. The last three market crashes was right before the elections, 2020, 2008, and 2000. If history repeats, oh, hey, look, 2008. And this is just credit card debt. 2020, it's just, here we go again. While everyone is distracted with AT&T and wars and blah, blah, digits go up, get to safety. Also, thanks for hanging out with me on Easter, right? Actually, I'm filming this. I have, what, a dozen people over, and they're like, where's Bravo? Oh, you know, he's working. I just feel like if I don't, no one else is going to show you this stuff. But anywho, love you guys, and I'll see you tomorrow.